In this video, we're going to talk about some of the properties of exponents. Earlier in the course, we introduced the idea of an exponent. So if you feel like you need to brush up on those, you're welcome to look back at those before starting this video. Just as a very brief refresher, what an exponent is it's a number that we write in the upper right-hand corner of another term called the base. And what this exponent means is we're going to multiply the base times itself repeatedly that number of times. So for example, if we wrote 3 to the 4th power, that means 4 is the exponent, where in this case 3 is called the base, and we would have 3 times 3 times 3 times 3, that's 4 times, because that's how large the exponent is. And so we can compute this number. 3 times 3 is 9. 9 times 3 is 27, and 27 times 3 is 81. So 3 raised to the 4th power would be 81. What we want to do in this video is go a little deeper than that. What happens if you have multiple terms that have exponents? What sort of properties do exponents have that can help us combine exponents and that sort of thing? So let me just run through these properties real quick here. And for each of these, I'll also show you just a small example. All right, the first one says that if you have x to the m times x to the n, where the bases match one another, this will be x to the m plus n. You add the exponents. You do not multiply the exponents. So for example, if you add 2 to the 2nd, maybe times 2 to the 3rd, since these bases match one another, we can say this is 2 to the 2 plus 3, which would make 5. And 2 to the 5th, we can actually compute. That's 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. That's 2 5 times. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. 8 times 2 is 16. 16 times 2 is 32. And so we see why this property works, actually. And I won't go into this much detail for the rest of the properties, but here's 2 to the 2nd times 2 to the 3rd. So if you have x to the m times x to the n, how many x's will you have total? You'll have m plus n. You'll have, in this case, 2 plus 3, which makes 5 of them total. So that's why we add the exponents for this particular property. All right, the next property, what happens when you have an exponent and then an exponent of the exponent, or of the term with the exponent? So a power to a power, what do we do in that case? Well, the property says that we'll take x to the m times n. So a power to a power, we're going to multiply. Let's say we had y to the 3rd and all of that raised to the 5th. Well, this property says we'd have y to the 3 times 5, which would be 15. Now, make sure you don't confuse these. A lot of students will mess this up and they'll want to add 3 and 5, and that's not correct. If it's a power to a power, you multiply, like in this case, and we get y to the 15th. The next property, what happens if you have x to the m divided by x to the n? Well, just like when we had multiplication, we added the exponents. Now that we have division, we'll subtract the exponents. So for example, let's say we had 7 to the 8th divided by 7 to the 6th. Well, then based off of this property, this should be 7 to the 8 minus 6, which would be 2. And 7 squared is 49. That's exactly right. We can also see this one graphically. If we have 7 times 7 times 7 times 7, 8 times, and then divided by 7 times 7 times 7, 6 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you'll see what's going to happen. A lot of these 7s will cancel. And in fact, every one of the 6 factors of 7 will cancel, leaving you with just 7 squared in the numerator. Next property, what if we have x over y? Here the bases may not be the same like we had previously, but x over y all to the nth power. Well, then you can distribute the power to the numerator and denominator. and get x to the m divided by, whoops, this should be y to the m. There is no n. Sorry about that. Little typo. X to the m divided by y to the m. So for example, if we had 2 over x to the third, then just think about what this would be long ways. This is 2 over x times 2 over x times 2 over x. That's 3 factors of 2 over x. 2 times 2 times 2 is 2 cubed, and x times x times x would make x cubed. So we could have skipped this middle step if we had noticed that 2 over x to the third would be 2 to the third divided by x to the third, right? So we're just using this property here. Now let's not leave it here though. 2 to the third is 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8. So we leave our final answer 8 over x to the third. Okay, final answer. All right, couple more and then we're done. What if we have different bases, x times y, all raised to the nth power? Then this would be x to the m times y to the m. The m distributes over multiplication. Now, as a quick little side note, I do want to make a caution because this is such a common mistake that I see from students. If you have x plus y to the m, then absolutely you cannot distribute the powers x to the m plus y to the m. Now you say, well, Devin, what's the difference? They look the same to me. This is addition and this is multiplication. Powers split over multiplication. They do not split over addition. So just be really careful about that because that's a super, super common mistake. All right, let's try an example. Let's say we had the quantity 3z to the third power. Well, if we didn't know this property to cube it, we'd have to take 3z times 3z times 3z. But then if you reorder all the terms, you'd get 3 to the third times z to the third. And sure enough, that would be this property. X times y to the m equals x to the m times y to the m. Now, anytime you have a numerical value raised to a power, if possible, go ahead and figure out what that is. 3 times 3 is 9. 9 times 3 makes 27. So we get 27z to the third. And the last one doesn't really need much of an explanation. X to the 0 power is automatically 1. So there's not really much of an example I can show you there. I think I can try to make up an example. If you had 5 to the third divided by 5 to the third, then using that property that we saw on the last page here, we should be able to subtract these exponents. So we get 5 to the 3 minus 3, which would make 5 to the 0. I think we'd all agree with that. But what is 5 to the third over 5 to the third? Those are the same thing, so that's going to give you 1. So that's how we have anything to the 0 power is 1. That means if you expressed it as a fraction, you'd have the same quantity in the numerator and denominator to give you an exponent of 0, and when they cancel, that'll equal 1. So anyways, this is just some properties that we have for exponents. I understand this was probably not the most exciting video, but we'll try to use some of these properties in some of our examples coming up shortly.